in your school or you are implementing in your school. So let's talk about it, of our today's topic. That is, basically we see sometimes in our school when the students have a bag which is basically very heavy for them, and they bring every day their bag and their notebooks are there, their books are there, which becomes little heavy for them. So teachers made some innovations to that and thought what we can do for students so they will not feel much burden of that bag. So teacher invented that is bag free day. So bag free day, as it sounds, that they, on that day, the students are not going to bring bag with them. So like this, so teachers chose one day, that was Saturday. On Saturday, no student will bring any bag. On that, all the students will learn by experience some different activities like that. So it means they are not bringing the bag to the school, but they are going to learn something in the school. So I'll share with you those innovative ideas with you. So let's talk about our first idea. That is general knowledge competition. In that, what teacher did, as we know that this is the era of competition and everybody is facing competition every day. So teacher thought how I can prepare my students to basically for competition in the real world. So teacher thought, let's do something. And teacher used to basically choose one topic for students. So teacher told student that please do not bring your bag tomorrow. So tomorrow you are going to come without bag, or a week before, like Saturday was a bag free day. So on Saturday, students are not going to bring a bag, and that brings excitement in students. After that, the students were so excited that we are going to do something very new in our school. So teacher prepared some questions for students. Once students comes in once all the students come in the class, after that teacher gives them one slip. In that slip, teacher writes some question related to any topic. If teacher chooses before 1 week any topic like science, political science or history or about India or about any other country or current situations, so students know that before 1 week that this will be the topic for us for next week. So teachers, students have enough time to prepare their topic. After that, what happens, teacher, all the students come in the class. So teacher makes sure that students are not sitting together. So if they sit together, so they can copy each other. So teacher make it sure that the students sit on the social distance. So one seat, one student sit on that. After that, teacher gives them one paper. On that paper, all the questions are written and all the students have enough time to write all the questions, all the answers of those questions. After that, after some time, teacher, when finishes the time, after that, teacher says to all the students, please cross pass your this paper or your exam paper. And after that, all the students passes that paper to another student. Or after that, another student check the another student's that exam paper. So what happens, the students develop the one skill of checking paper or evaluating somebody else. So after that, teacher takes a notebook and start reading the answer of all those questions which teacher gave them in that exam. So if there is any student who do not know the answer of any question, so that student also come to know. Or if any student is there who has written the wrong answer of that, he confirms that my answer was wrong and this is the right answer of my question. And if we have any student who has written all the questions right, so he feels good or she feels good of that at that time and knows that my answer is right. And at the end, whosoever answers the most questions, that student is a winner. So this was the single based activity. Now let's talk about the group. In group also written activity can be done. So what teacher did, teacher thought I will make some groups. In those groups, I will divide some students, like 4 students in a group, one group, and 4 or 5 groups are there. After that, teacher gave them one exam paper and all the questions were there. So all the students have to basically talk to each other, find the answer or make a, or create an answer, because topic can be anything or topic can be related to any other their mindset or any other political science, like what is the situation in India right now. If this question is there, so if there are 5 students in a group, so there will be 5 different answers which can make one answer very good. So like this teacher did. Now let's talk about the oral activity. In oral activity, what teacher did, in that teacher did not give any paper to any student. So teacher divided some groups, like 5 students in one group. After that, teacher asked one group some questions, like if I, for an example, teacher asked 10 questions to one group. If there is any group who is answering the most questions, that group will be the winner of that Saturday. So like this, so students get enough chance to answer. They basically develop teamwork in them and they do not feel burdened. They have an excitement in their in the class that we do not have any bag. We are just going to have a competition, a healthy competition like that. So all the students have a feel, very good feel in them. And every Saturday they feel excitement once they come in school. So let's talk about another idea. That is basically sometimes we see in our class that science is very difficult to teach in one room. If we want to give real life experience to our students, so it becomes sometimes little difficult. Like if I want to teach my students about leaf, so how can I teach in my class that what are the veins on the leaf and different kind of leaves are there? If I want to give them time to basically find everything, because everything which is around us, that is science. So teacher thought what I can do for that. So they invented Science Park. In Science Park, what teacher did on Saturday, teacher told that you are not going to bring your bag today. Only you will come free hand. So after that student came, teacher gave them topic that this is the park. We are sitting here. Before that teacher finds one tree, a tree which has shade. So basically all the students can sit there comfortably. And after that, all the students can talk or have good discussion. So tree like that. All the students are going to sit on grass. And after that, teacher says to all the students, please go and find any material which you see in the park or in the school. And after that, you have to prepare any material or any topic which you are going to explain and which can be related to science. So like this, student got one chance to basically develop a new thing and or fight with their mind. So sometimes what happens when we give them topic, so it becomes a little hard for them. So better if we ask them to do something which they can do by their own. So in this, on Saturdays, teacher give the topic that this is the material or you have to find this material and then create a new material here, which you can explain and tell us the use of that. So students come to know how they can in their real life. So this becomes a problem sometimes. So most of the students, whatever they learn in the class, so they have one question that how can we use this knowledge in us, in our real life? So this activity basically answers them how they can basically use the science in their real life. So this was the activity Science Park. I hope you like it. And if you like it, so do not forget to basically implement in your school. So now let's talk about our next idea, that is hanging library. As it sounds, that hanging library, so something is hanging in that. So this is basically an idea behind is the teacher saw that all the students come in my class and after that they go to library and they start taking reading book. So sometimes they feel little bore or they basically lose the interest in reading book. And as we know, book reading is very important for creating a good mindset of student. So teacher thought what I can do for my students. So basically they basically read book in an open space. So teacher created that hanging library. So teacher found one tree there. Teacher can basically hang some strips. On the strips, teacher writes some thoughts on that. Thoughts, questions, queries, like that. So when teacher calls all the students in that park or near to that tree and ask all the students go and read all these papers and see what are on the strips, and then we will discuss it. And after that, students, they go and they read all these strips. And after reading those strips, teachers sees that what students are understanding and teacher asks sometime one by one or group discussion is there. And after that, on the branch of that tree, teacher keeps book there and asks students that it will be completely your choice to choose any book which you want to read. And why teacher thought about it? Because what happens when students are reading book in class or in library? So they keep looking at the window and see that how birds are basically flying and what is happening outside, how tree looks like. So they keep looking at this. So teacher thought I will give the same environment to my all the students so they can basically feel the open space study. So students start choosing the books, and after choosing all the books, they come and sit near to the tree and on the grass and start studying. So if for one or two Saturday, the students start understanding about the nature and the love of the nature and how they can study in the near to the nature or if they go outside. Because book reading is not only for library, book reading is for every place. So if we want to develop any book reading habit in our student, so first we have to make them realize that book reading cannot be done only in library only, it can be done anywhere. So it is the best example how they can read in the park a book. So it was the hanging library which teacher found very good results of that. So these were the three ideas of bag free day. And so everyone, I want to offer you, if you are implementing any idea like this in your school, or if you are planning to do something, so I give you the chance to please share with me so all the people on Facebook can see you. Please feel free to ask your question or share what you do in your school so students can feel less burden and they can learn more. Yes, do we have any teacher who would like to ask any question? You can write on your comment box or you can ask freely here. Or you can share your experience, how you basically teach in your school without any burden and how you give new experience to all these students so they can learn freely. So, okay, everyone. So let's meet tomorrow with another idea. I hope you like it and implement in your school. Till then, bye-bye. Have a great day.